You know, we all understand how important footwork is in high-performance tennis. And many coaches say, move your feet, move your feet, move your feet. But moving your feet is difficult. And we're going to go through a lesson today and teach you how to better move your feet. And this lesson actually spins off from one of our subscribers here on YouTube, Francis, who asked, how do I get my feet going? And in today's lesson, I'm going to give you some great tips to help you do just that. So for me, moving my feet is really a mindset first. If I get my mind in the mindset and the thinking process of moving my feet, it becomes much easier. So for me, it begins with my thinking and then it translates into what I do physically. So when you're on the court, the first thing I want you to do is establish a ready position where you're down in your legs a little bit, you've got a nice wide stance, and you are ready to go, and you're on the balls of your feet, and you're ready to go, and you're bouncing, you're loose, okay? You've just got a nice bounce going. I have never seen a tennis player in that position who wasn't focused. So the two kind of go hand in hand, the physical and the mental. So you've really got to get this mindset that I'm going to get on the balls of my feet and I'm going to stay in motion the whole time I'm playing. The value of footwork, of course, is mobility, it's balance, and it's rhythm. And without footwork, nothing else is going to come together and give you a chance to play your best tennis. So we're going to go through a couple more things that are really going to help you improve your footwork on the court. One of the most valuable tools to develop good footwork and really build the muscles to help you have good footwork is the jump rope. And the jump rope is great because when you're skipping rope, your feet are always touching the court to leave the court again. And that's exactly what you're doing when you're playing tennis. The only time your feet are going to plant is to play a stroke and then you carry on in your footwork again. So a lot of footwork is also gliding or semi-skipping footwork. And that using the jump rope makes that rhythm happen naturally. So get yourself a rope and get out and work on it. And the first thing you want to do is just establish a good rhythm. So get a good rhythm going where you feel like you could do 100 of them. Get the feel of doing that. Okay. Now what happens to most players, most people in the jump rope, they get to a certain point and they get bored. And they stop concentrating and then they catch the rope on the foot. I'm going to give you a series of exercises that are going to help you focus on something. It's going to help your rope skipping. It's going to help you become a much better athlete. And what I call it is combinations and transitions. Combinations and transitions is working the rope back and forth between the feet so that you have something specific to focus on. And you're also working on isolating one leg and then the other and then the two together. And it really helps you identify where maybe perhaps one leg is either weaker or less coordinated than the other. And it helps balance that strength and that coordination. And it really helps you build your footwork skills. So specifically, when you're doing the combinations and transitions routine on the jump rope, I start out with 10 skips on both feet to get my rhythm and get my timing and tempo. And then I transition and I do two jumps on the right foot. And then I go to both feet for two jumps, and then the left foot for two jumps, and then back to both feet for the two jumps. Then I switch to four. Four on the right, four on both, four on the left, four on both. Six on the right, six on both, six on left, six on both, and so on. So I just wanted to be clear that that's the sequence that you want to build. And if you break in the middle of the sequence, just pick up where you started and just keep going and see if you can get to the end. And eventually, you're going to be able to just plow through this routine and make it look really easy. And you're going to really discover how it's going to help you move better on the court. So this combinations and transitions drill with the rope keeps you focused, and it really isolates and builds the muscle groups. It helps you coordinate one leg to the other and keep balance. The only way you can really skip rope with control is to be balanced. So it really helps in all of those things. The other thing that's important too is that you establish a tempo that's realistic. It wouldn't be realistic for me to skip so fast that it wouldn't be like that on the tennis court for me, or so slow that it would not really simulate what I do on the court either. So the tempo that I'm building there is the tempo I feel like I play with most of the time. And if you can get skillful with this rope, when you get on the tennis court, you just feel like you're in that mode where you can push and move, your legs feel strong and they feel springy, and you feel light on your feet. And that's the feeling you really want to get when you're playing. You want to make this hard court, in this case, a hard court here out in California, we play on hard courts. I want to make this court feel soft, like a springboard. So I'm light in my legs, I'm springy, and I'm touching the court softly, and it will really help you. So the key to great footwork is to be a good athlete and get in motion. And when you're on the tennis court and the ball's live, stay in motion, keep your feet lively. and get a jump rope and work on your rope skipping skills. It will build your timing, it'll build your coordination, your focus, and it will help balance out the strength of your legs and make you a much better athlete on the court. And that is going to help you get to more balls, keep your balance better, and produce much better shots. So I strongly encourage you, focus on your footwork, become the best athlete you can be, and stay in motion at all times when the ball is live. I hope you really enjoyed and benefited from this lesson today. It was a lot of fun making it for you. Thank you for watching it. And please, give us a like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, leave us a comment below. If you have a video you'd like us to make for you, we'd be glad to do it. Just let us know in the comments section. And if you click into our descriptive section down below, click on the link and get access to our complete library of free lessons that focus on the fundamental skills you need to learn to achieve your full potential in tennis. We'll look forward to seeing you in the next video.